The Faulkner Auto Racing Championships are proud to present the Smash Beer Low Dollar Series, the crown jewel of FARC competition. Today it is the final race of the round of 15 in the 2016 FARC Off, and it's a doubleheader event. The Vickers Collision and Glass Double at the Grand Detour of Western Illinois, the infamous Death Bowl. And here is the starting grid for race number one of the Vickers Collision and Glass Double. 40 cars will be starting this race. Starting at the back is Thomas Tucker in the 99 car, alongside Trek Togger in the 74. Row 19, we have Jackie Thompson for Laser Motorsports, alongside Leslie Riggs, a FARC Off contender. Row 18 sees John Burr and Todd Stater, another FARC Off contender. Row 17 has Rick Lewis in the 9th Plan Racing Machine, and Anthony Griffith for Team Thunder. And row 16 is Chuck Johnson for Cat Motorsports, and inside of him is Taylor Brillen for Motor Assault Racing. And row 15 is Stanley Parsons for Wesley Family Racing. Inside of him is Timothy Ruiz in the 112 car. Row 14 sees Kenny Brillen and Mike Malone for Knuckles Racing. Row 13 has FARC Off contender Johnson Clapp and Kurt Walker. Row 12 is Jason Bates with Wild West Racing and another FARC Off contender, Greg Gray. And row 11 is Zach Gott for Gravity Racing Incorporated and Billy Ray Smith Thompson for Pearson Swinging Motorsports, another FARC Off contender. Row 10 sees two more FARC Off contenders and M&J Racing teammates Kevin Monroe and Mark Thompson. In row 9, Billy Bob Choders and Lev Azarov for Roos Autosport, another FARC Off contender. In row 8, we have Riley Durbin and Keegan Mallory for AJY Racing. Row 7 sees two more FARC Off contenders in Bradley Carlisle and Kenny George III. Row 6 is Joshua Pacer driving for Jones Sport this week and Z-Dane Quackenbush for Gravity Racing Incorporated. In row 5 is Jim Kidd with Power Surge America, and right beside him is Gio Arias for Ike Durbin Incorporated. Row 4 sees Ricky McKenzie and another FARC Off contender, Daniel Lecklider, driving for his own team. Row 3 is Tyron Key and Ben Atkins driving for Desert Star Motorsports. Row 2 has Monica Rook and Kelly Spliceson for Terra International. And starting on the front row is Bob Steffens with Team Thunder, and on the pole, Danica Hollifield for SWH Racing. And here are the 10 drivers who failed to qualify for race one. One of those being FARC Off contender Tristan Kristoff, which is a bit of a surprise even though he is driving for Team Burr. However, if one or more cars fail to qualify, then any of these drivers or all these drivers could get into the race, second race. Among those who also failed to qualify, Zach Webster, Kira Smith, Truman Elson, Barry Woods, Mariana Zavala, Maury Holter, Troy Peterson, Dale Clough, and Tom Brayton. And here comes the field to the green flag for 80 laps here at Grand Detour. That'll be the distance for both races here today. As the green flag flies, Danica Hallfield leads the field to the green flag, but she's already under attack from the 96 of Kelly Spliceson off of turn two. Here comes Ben Atkins in the 83, our former Dash Cup champion, coming to the inside as well, as he's alongside Bob Steffens for the third spot. But Spliceson will lead here at the end of lap number one. So already a lead change here in this race as Ben Atkins dives to the inside of the 25 car to take over the second spot. That 25 car doesn't look like it's handling good right now, as the 86 of Gio Arias bounces off the wall a little bit coming off of turn two. I've seen a lot of that in practice for today's race, as Greg Gray does a little bit of a dive bomb, but it's a bit of a not so good move as he gets into Gio Arias as well as a couple cars, and there's a huge wreck on the front stretch. And FARC officials immediately throw the red flag. We have a couple cars. Well, one car's already upside down. Boy, what the heck happened here? The 78 dive bombed underneath the 82 of Lev Azarov. Got the 9 of Taylor Brillen and Kevin Monroe involved. Got Greg Gray dive bombed underneath of Lev Azarov and Gio Arias. And it really didn't work out, as they went three wide, and coming off of turn four, that's really not going to work. Over the 88 of Joshua Pacer, FARC Off contender, the 66 of Todd Stater, and also a FARC Off contender, receiving heavy, heavy damage. And judging from the smoke from that 88 car, I'd say he's done for the day. Boy, and this just on the second lap of the race. 46 looks like he got some damage. And we're going to keep track of things here. Two cars have already flipped over on their lid as we go on board with Jason Bates with Wild West Racing. He picks the right line, the low line, and he is able to get around the wreck. And here's another FARC off contender, Bradley Carlisle. Right in the middle of this mess, he slows down to avoid it, but gets punted from behind. Goes the 69. There's the 29. She gets flipped up. Leslie Riggs, she gets flipped up on her lid. Heck of a ride she took. Boy, a lot of cars damaged in this one here on the second lap of the race. As we go back under yellow, 21 cars were involved. Bradley Carlisle, Taylor Brillin, Jim Kidd, Rick Lewis, Kenny Brillin, Keegan Mallory, Leslie Riggs, Riley Durbin, Chuck Johnson, and John Burr. As well as Kevin Monroe, Todd Stater, Johnson Clamp, Zach Gott, Truck Togger, Greg Gray, Lev Azarov, Gio Arias, Joshua Pacer, Jackie Thompson, and Stanley Parsons. 9 of the 15 FARC-off contenders were involved in this crash in one way or another. So, yeah, not the way you want to start a race here, as the green flag flies once again. They red flagged the race for about 20 minutes to get everything cleaned back up. And once they did, the 96 of Kelly Splicen reassumes the lead. But caution flies soon after for yet another tumble as the 26 of Kirby Krieger and Trek Togger get together. And that brings our tumble count up to 3 as Togger goes for a wild ride. He was able to get going though. And a couple more cars were involved. 38 of Riley Durbin and Jackie Thompson in the 91. Both were innocent victims in that one. They were just falling along behind when that happened. It's a tough break for them. This was not the only incident of the caution though, as Jason Bates gets into the 5 of Mike Malone a little bit and sends him up the track in turn 4. However, Malone was able to get going. But there was yet another incident under this caution as the 10 of Daniel Lechleiter gets into the wall a little bit. And coming off of turn 4, too little too space for 3 cars right there as Billy Ray Smith Thompson, Daniel Lechleiter, and Kurt Walker get together. And the 427 of Stanley Parsons takes a little bit of a steep borders grind on the outside wall. Boy, a bit of a hard hit right there. 3 incidents in 1 lap. Unbelievable. And he does a little bit of a roll, so that brings our tumble count up to 4. And we're only 8 laps into this race. Man, that's Grand Detour for you. After they get that sorted out, green flag comes back out once again with Kelly Splicen in the lead. Ben Atkins running in the second position. And Kevin Monroe is on the inside, currently a couple laps down. But he's challenging Splicen to try to get one of those laps back as Ben Atkins gets a nice run in turns 3 and 4. And he has a run off of turn 4. Heading down the front stretch and into turn 1 for the race lead, and he is able to clear the 96 as well as the 7 of Bob Steffens. He'll take over the second spot. Whoa, as the 63 and 83 come together. 2 former champions colliding there a little bit and getting loose. Kevin Monroe, former FARC champion, and Ben Atkins, former champion of the Dash Cup Series. That slows both of their momentum. And the 96 of Splicen says, thank you very much, I'll just take the lead like right back. And because the lead technically didn't change at the start-finish line, no lead change is counted. So, tough break for Ben Atkins there, who took the lead momentarily, but it will not count. As Bob Steffens tries to find a winner underneath him. Lev Azarov and Riley Durbin, who were involved in the lap 2 crash, have to come down pit road. Durbin's been doing laps in the pit when he met cars significantly damaged. Lev Azarov has to come in for a flat tire. Tough break for him. As the 96 of Splicen gets up and into the wall while running in the race lead, and this is going to cost her as Ben Atkins takes advantage and takes over the lead for the first time today with Bob Steffens in tow in the 7 car. So Splicen drops back to 3rd, and there's Danica Holifield in the 25 and 4th. And here comes Bob Steffens with a run on Atkins for the lead in turns 1 and 2, and he will take it. Despite the fact that Steffens has been in the FARC series for 10 years, he has never won, believe it or not. As talented as Bob Steffens has been, you would think he would have a few race wins under his belt, but nope, no wins yet. Could today be the day as he takes over the lead for the first time today? Billy Ray Smith Thompson's day comes to an early end as he experiences an engine failure. Tough break for him as he was basically on the bubble in the FARC off coming into today's race, and this may very well end his hopes for a championship here this season. I'll have to wait and see what happens in race 2, but certainly not what he wanted. 71 as Zach Gott gets a little bit loose off of turn 2 and goes for a lazy spin. bringing out the third caution on lap number 20. Fortunately, nobody else gets into him, and he's able to continue on without a problem, albeit with some flat spot tires, which he comes in and gets changed. And we come to the fourth restart of the day, and Stephens continues to lead the way with Lev Azarov on his inside, trying to get a couple laps back, as is Kevin Monroe in the 63 car, as Stephens gets away from the 96 a little bit. But Stephens, coming off of turn two, gets into the wall a little bit. We've been seeing that a lot in practice. And that's going to allow the 96 of Kelly Splyson to take advantage and retake the lead from Stephens as they come back to the caution flag. So it'll be the second time that Splyson's led today. Coming off of turn four, the 98 of Kurt Walker and the 427 of Stanley Parsons come together. This is the second time today that they've done that. They were involved in the lap. In the second caution of the day. This one coming out on lap number 28, caution number 4. Parsons is able to get it back going again and maintains his position. One driver who was happy to see this caution was the 82 of Lev Azarov, who gets one of his laps back. So a guy running for the championship right now, certainly happy to see that. As we come back to the green flag, Kelly Splyson once again your leader with the 7 of Bob Stephens running in second. And Danica Holifield currently running in the third position, showing that qualifying up front here at Grand Detour is usually the way to go. As these drivers have been running up front from pretty much drop of the green flag, and that includes Ben Atkins in the 83, who just got around Holifield. But here's a guy who started dead last on the field and is off to the top five. That is Thomas Tucker in the 99 car. As the 7 gets into the wall a little bit and he loses some spots. Whoa! As the 99 gets into Holifield a little bit. But that actually helped Holifield a little bit because she gets a nice run through turns 1 and 2. And is actually underneath the vacuums to try to challenge for the second spot. And a tough break for Lev Azarov as he has to come down pit road once again. And he takes it in a little too hot and smacks the inside of the pit wall. He's able to get it back to his pit stall, but he's going to lose a lot more laps than the ones he lost. And the 5 of Mike Malone also has to come down pit road as he's having troubles as well. That's the 462 of Ricky McKenzie, who started inside the top 10 today, but not having a good run right now as he scraped the wall right there. The 50 of Kenny George III, a FARC off contender. Whoa, as he scrapes the turn 4 wall coming off of turn 4. Not been a good day for him either in the 50 car. Oh, as he almost touches the 74 as he goes 3 wide with the 22. But both these guys' days about to get a lot worse as the 50 slides up and into the 462 off of turn 2, sending the 462 car over. Boy, that was a wild ride from McKenzie there, bringing out the 5th caution of the day and bringing our tumble count up to 5. So we haven't even hit the halfway point of this race and we've had 5 cars go over. Several other cars were also involved in this incident as the 462 is able to get it back going again. But I'd say he took some significant damage to the steering in that car because as he's trying to drive it back to the pits, he hits the end of the pit wall. Of course, considering the impact he just took, I'd say the steering was pretty well damaged in that one. Trek Togger and Monica Rook were also involved in this. Rook taking some heavy, heavy damage as well, which is going to put her out of today's race. So a tough break for Monica Rook. She's having a decent run here today. But wrong place, wrong time. But one guy happy to see his caution, Kevin Monroe in the 63 car, as he gets another lap back. I believe that's the second lap he's gotten back today, so that certainly helps his cause as the green flag comes back out once again. Look at the top 4, the 96 of Splyson, the 83 of Ben Atkins, under pressure from Danica Holifield, but Holifield gets it loose off of turn 4 into the 54 of John Burr, and that's going to send both cars around as she's battling for the second spot. Oh, this is going to be trouble as the 54 is hit by someone, and then the 10 of Daniel Lechleiter, nowhere to go. And neither, same can be said for the 26 of Kirby Krieger. And then the 25 gets into the 26. Wow. What the heck happened here? So the 25 got into the 54 off of turn 2, which got both cars loose. And spinning down the backstretch, here's the 10 of Daniel Lechleiter. Ooh, as he hits the 51 hard, sending him over, and then he gets hit hard by the 26. Oh, it's actually Keegan Mallory, excuse me. Kirby Krieger is a driver in that car, but today it's Keegan Mallory. And it turned out it was the 64 Mark Thompson who got into the 54 a little bit. And it was the hit from the 10 that sends the 54 over. And that is tumble number 6. So this was a lot bigger wreck than I think it should have been, but again, that's a Grand Detour for you. And 86 also received some damage as he got hit by the tumbling 54 car, so he received some damage to the left side. This has not been a good day for Gio Arias at all. He's been involved in several incidents today. And 26, nowhere to go for him. And he hits the 54. And the 25 gets into him. Bad day just got a lot worse for Keegan Mallory. And that's going to pretty much end his day as well on the 26 car. So after yet another lengthy cleanup, the green flag comes back out with Kelly Splicing continuing to lead the way. 82 of Lev Azarov on the inside trying to get one of his laps back. He's lost a lot of laps. And here comes Ben Atkins in the 83, and right behind him is the 99 of Thomas Tucker. Again, Tucker started dead last in this race, and he is up to third, and we're just past the halfway point of the race. So a very impressive run by Thomas Tucker in the 99 car. Another guy making a great run is the 46 of Chuck Johnson, who got his first career win earlier this season to get himself into the FARC off. Former Bar Super Pro Series champion back when it was called the National Pro Cup Championship. So he certainly has some championship pedigree to him, and he's looking for a FARC championship to go along with that. As Splicing once again smacks the turn 3 and 4 wall. She's able to get back off of it though, unlike the previous time. As Ben Atkins continues to hold down the runner-up spot, but he gets up a little bit high and smacks the turn 2 wall a little bit, so that's going to cost him some time. And that's going to bring Thomas Tucker and Chuck Johnson into the fray as the two battle for the third position. Oh, but the 46 and the 99 make contact. Coming off of turn 4 and both get sent into the wall. Chuck Johnson goes for a tumble down the front stretch. Ooh, and he gets smacked by someone as we're up to 7 tumbles here today. Boy, I imagine that's not going to make Johnson very happy. You take a look from the aerial view. Couldn't really tell who was at fault for that one, if it was the 99 or the 46. Slow it down a little bit and see what happens here. 46 is coming up the track a little bit. The 99 comes down. Yeah, it looks like a case of racing incident right there, because the 46 was coming up the track, the 99 was coming down. They both went for the same space and made contact, so I'd say that was a racing incident right there. Although I don't think the 46 is going to take too kindly to that, as the 5 was the one who got into the 46, and it sets off yet another pileup heading down into turn 1. The 427 not able to avoid it, and the 98 hits him again. Not intentionally, of course, but that's the third time that's happened today. And the 50 of Kenny George III, as well as the 64 of Mark Thompson, and the 86 of Gio Arias also involved. This one's going to take Kenny George III out of the race. Tough break for him. He's been at the back of the FARC-off points pretty much since the first race. And this may have ended his championship hopes as the green flag comes out. And coming up into the fray now is the 07 of Anthony Griffith. He's now moved his way up into the second spot, getting around Ben Atkins. Ooh, the 96 scraping the wall a little bit as the 82 gets another one of his laps back. That probably would have cost Splicing the lead, but the caution is out once again as the 86 of Gio Arias once again gets into an incident, goes 3 wide with the 09 of Jason Bates and the 112 of Timothy Ruiz. This time, however, it's just a little spin in turn 4, and he's able to gather it back up. The 09 of Jason Bates nearly loses it coming off of turn 4, but is able to keep it going in the right direction, and keeps this from being a much bigger incident than it should have. And it probably should have, I should say. That caution came out on lap 61 as the green flag flies, and thankfully it was the final caution of this race. And the 07 of Anthony Griffith has a great start. And coming down the backstretch, he has a run on 96 for the race lead. Anthony Griffith looking for his first victory since 2011, I believe, at Verdugo. So It has been a long time since Griffith has seen the winner's circle. The 96 of Kelly Splyson has never visited the winner's circle. Meantime, here's a candidate for restart of the day as the 71 is that guy. He still found that inside lane a little bit. He restarted in the 10th position. And he just got around the 1683, smacked the wall a little bit. So he loses a lot of momentum. And the 71 taking advantage of that is now up to the 7th position. Ooh, the 18 smacked the wall a little bit. And here comes Gott underneath the 82 and the 7 of Bob Steffens. Steffens gets back around him. But as you're going to see in two laps, he goes from 10th to 5th. And Steffens moves up to 4th. But oh, Gott smacks the wall pretty hard off turn 2. So that's going to stunt his momentum a little bit as the 83 of Ben Atkins tries to get back underneath him to challenge for the 5th position. But pretty good restart by Gott there. He started about midfield as well. But good run for him. Good run for Ben Atkins. As well as the 16. Here's the 09 of Jason Bates. He's made his way up into the top 5 and is challenging the 07. And the 7, Team Thunder Cars, he's sandwiched in between us as the 07 of Griffith gets into the outside wall. That's going to cost him 2 spots as Bates and his teammate Steffens gets around. And here comes Steffens underneath of Bates. That's for the 2nd spot as Splyson has gotten away a little bit in the 96 car. The 09 drifts up a little bit, and he goes into the wall as well and turns 3 or 4. That's going to cost him the 2nd spot as Steffens gets around him. And the 96 is Splyson. She gets into the turn 2 wall. Boy, she's starting to feel the pressure now as the 7 of Bob Steffens is now closing the gap. Neither of these drivers has ever won a FARC Smash Beer Low Dollar Series event. Inside of 5 laps to go, they have their shot right here. And a tough break for Ben Atkins as he has to peel off into the pit lane. Overheating issues for the 83 car puts him out of the race with just a few laps to go, which means he won't be able to start race 2 either. What a heartbreaker for Atkins, who is running top 5 pretty much all race long. Former Dash Cup champion and was close to victory here today, but engine problem's going to put him out. And Steffens with a huge run on Splyson off of turn 4, and he is going to clear the 96 car for the lead in turns 1 and 2 as Splyson comes up and smacks the turn 2 wall, as does Lewis in the 19 car. He smacked it really hard, nearly went over. But it's got to be a heartbreaker for Splyson, who has led a lot of this race, 67 laps. But now finds herself trailing the 7 car as Steffens takes the white flag. But Splyson not going to give up as she has a huge run in turns 1 and 2. Thomas Tucker's closing the gap a little bit as well, but he hits the turn 2 wall. Splyson with a huge run in turns 3 and 4, making one last attempt to take the win away. But she gets loose off of turn 4, and after 10 years of trying, Bob Steffens finally has his first career FARC Smash Beer Low Dollar Series victory in a thrilling finish here in race number 1. In fact, Bob Steffens is the only FARC off driver in the top 10, and his victory will guarantee him a spot in the round of 10. Splyson comes home 2nd, gotta be a heartbreaker for her. Thomas Tucker comes home in 3rd after starting 40th. Kurt Walker, despite his problems, comes home 4th, Anthony Griffith in 5th, Zach Gott 6th, Billy Bob Chiller 7th, Danica Hollifield 8th, Jason Bates in 9th, and Timothy Ruiz. And the Ruiz Paul Motorsports machine comes home in the 10th position, so great run for him. For race number 2, the starting grid will be based on the finishing order for race number 1, which means that Bob Steffens will be starting on the pole for race number 2. And drivers who fail to qualify will get spots in the race 2 starting grid to replace the drivers who fell out. And because of that, there are only 30 cars starting in race number 2, because only half the field finished race 1. In row 15, Tom Brayton and Dale Clough. Row 14 sees Troy Peterson and Maury Halter. Row 13 has Barry Woods and Mariana Zavala for M&J Racing. Row 12 sees Truman Ellison and Kira Smith for Terra International. Row 11 sees Zach Webster, her teammate, and Tristan Kristoff, a FARC-off competitor who failed to qualify for race 1, but will now be able to race here in race number 2. Row 10 sees Riley Durbin, who circled the track in the pit lane, but was able to finish the race. Lev Azarov inside of him. Row 9 sees Gio Arias, who was pretty much in every incident under the sun, it seemed like, in race 1, and Rick Lewis inside of him. Mark Thompson and Jim Kidd wake up row 8. Jackie Thompson and Kevin Monroe in row number 7. Row 6 sees Bradley Carlisle and Tyron Key for SWH Racing in row number 6. Row 5 sees Timothy Ruiz and Jason Bates inside of him. Row 4 has Danica Hollifield and Billy Bob Childers. Row 3 has a couple of Ohio drivers, Zach Gott for Gravity Racing Incorporated and Anthony Griffith for Team Thunder. Row 2 has Kurt Walker for Walker Texas Racing and Thomas Tucker for Ashley Croft Family Racing. And in row number 1, Kelly Spleissen for Terra International and the winner of race number 1, Bob Steffens for Team Thunder. And here comes the field down for race number 2, once again 80 laps. This time only 30 cars starting this race because, well, only 20 cars finished race 1. So basically half the field as Steffens gets a good start and pulls out ahead of the field. Thomas Tucker moves up into the second position. Can't believe he started in 40th in race number 1 and raced his way to a third place position. So Tucker having a good day so far and hoping to keep it going. Here's the 8 of Bradley Carlisle. Based on the fact that he finished race 1 and managed to get into race 2, one of only a few FARC-off drivers to do so, based on points right now, it seems like a guarantee that he is going to be advancing to the round of 10. Not going to say anything yet, but we'll wait and see what happens here in race number 2. But having a good run right now as he gets underneath of Thomas Tucker to get himself up into the top 5. Team Thunder teammates battling for the lead as Griffith has a run underneath of the 7 of Bob Steffens, and he'll easily take it down the backstretch. Kelly Spleissen right behind him in the third position, and Jason Bates in the 09 car right behind them as well. So action fast and furious here in race number 2 of the Grand Detour double. Ooh, but Anthony Griffith looked like he scraped the wall a little bit coming off of turn 2, and that's going to allow Bob Steffens to get a run back underneath him for the lead. But it looks like Griffith will be able to hold his teammate at bay, at least for right now. Much cleaner start, but it's about to get a little messy as the 100 of Tom Brayton hits the turn 2 wall, comes down, and Zach Gott with nowhere to go. The 100 takes a terrible tumble down the backstretch, and that brings our total up to 8. Nowhere for Gott to go. And that's going to cause a bit of a pileup as he gets hit by the 51 and the 63. Looks like the 91 of Jackie Thompson also gets into him. And the smoking engine indicates that the 71 is done for the day. And Gott was none too pleased with Tom Brayton, basically calling him a crappy driver and all that jazz. But anyways, I kind of... I kind of censored what he kind of said there, but 4 other cars were involved. Lev Azarov, Gio Arias, Jackie Thompson, and Thomas Tucker, all involved in this incident. Gio Arias, man, he is taking a pounding here in this weekend. He'll be one of those drivers that'll be glad when Grand Detour is done and over with. Something we did not see in race number 1, pit stops. Here on the first caution of the day, which came out on lap number 10, a lot of drivers taking tires here in this race, even though it's an 80 lap race. So a little bit of a surprise compared to race number 1. Griffith wins the race off of pit road, but it's the 64 of Mark Thompson who decides to stay out, and he will be the new race leader. Thompson, the only driver this season with multiple race wins. He has 2 already this season as he takes the lead and takes the green flag in the lead with Tyron Key right behind him in second as the 40 of Barry Woods gets up and into the turn 2 wall. But here comes the 09 of Jason Bates underneath of everybody, including the 51 car, and he will take over the second position. Here comes Anthony Griffith in the 07 back into the picture. Both of these guys on fresh tires, whereas the 51 and the 64 are not, but the 51 fighting back on the inside to try to retake the second position from Jason Bates. He has a bit of a run off of turn four, but can't quite make the pass stick. And here comes the 18 of Jim Kidd underneath the 07 of Anthony Griffith. And now he has a run underneath the 51. I believe the 18 was another driver who took four tires on that pit stop. And now he has a run underneath the 09 of Jason Bates for the second position. So this 18 car on a bit of a march here early on in race number two. He's really right on the back bumper of that 09 car. 09 Bates slides up just a little bit in turn two. Here comes Kidd underneath. He has a great run through turns three and four. And he'll easily clear the 09 car to take over the second position. And here comes Tyron Key to try to take the third position away. Here comes Kurt Walker in the 98 to challenge. Ooh, but he gets up and into Key off of turn two. Brings out the second caution on lap 25. He gets the car back going again, but then smashes the end of the pit wall. Yeah, that's definitely a candidate for WTF moment of the race, as the 64 decides to come down pit road and take fresh tires himself. Interesting strategy. He will have fresher tires than everyone else. And just like last time, this time Jim Kidd stays out, and he will inherit the race lead. His teammate, the 16 of Billy Bob Childers, is right behind him in the second position. The 00 of Troy Peterson is on the tail end of the lead lap. Ooh, as the 40 and 55 get together a little bit, which certainly jams up the field a little bit. And here comes the 82 of Lev Azarov with no front end, but this is for the race lead. Yes, you heard me correctly, as the 18 gets into the 00 and turns him around, which consequently turns his teammate around. And the 16 car, Billy Bob Childress, who took over the second position. Whoa, the 96 with a nice bit of avoidance there. Well, that could have been bad for Splicing, but a great bit of avoidance on her part, as the 00 of Troy Peterson spins around and is collected by the 07 of Anthony Griffith and the 09 of Jason Bates. Both sustaining some damage in that one, so tough break for both those guys, as the 00 is able to get back going again. But the 40 around on the back stretch. What the heck happened here? And the 09 is smoking, so that indicates he's probably going to be done for the day with engine damage. But he spins the 40 out on the back stretch. I guess trying to get some pit road, and that causes the 55 and Maury Halter to sustain some damage. I would imagine that the FARC officials are not going to be happy about that one. And prior to this caution, the 64 Mark Thompson has to come down pit road for an emergency pit stop for a loose wheel. So, wow, tough break for Mark Thompson, who now has to start one lap down, but he is on the inside, so he has a chance to make that up. I believe he's actually a couple laps down as the 82 restarts in the race lead, but scrapes the wall four wide down the backstretch, and somehow they make it work as the 18 of Jim Kidd takes over the lead from the 82 car. And wow, who is that coming up the inside? That's the 38 of Riley Durbin, as the 96 takes over the second spot from the 82. Let's watch the 38 here on this restart, as he's lapped down here. And the 64 is actually one lap down. The 38 gets a nice start, and look at that, four wide right in front of him. But he doesn't panic, and he actually has the very, very inside line in turns three and four, and he gets around all of those cars. So a great restart by Riley Durbin. It doesn't get him back on the lead lap yet, but it does give him a much nicer position should the caution come back out, as Splicing smacks the wall pretty hard in turns one and two. 55 of Maury Halter gets loose and up and into the 8 of Bradley Carlisle, and the 55 of Maury Halter, or the 40 of Barry Woods, excuse me, and the 55 takes a lazy spin down the backstretch, bringing out the fourth caution of the day at the halfway point of the race, lap number 40. A guy happy to see this was the 64 of Mark Thompson, who is able to get back onto the lead lap, as he was ahead of the leader at the time of the caution flag. And the current leader of the race right now is Jim Kidd in the 18 car, and right behind him, Lev Azarov in the 82, with no front end on that car. He was involved in the first caution of the day, and they spent some time cutting off the front of that car. Basically looks like a modified, but here he is racing for the lead. It's just pretty crazy right now. The 16 of Billy Bob Childers right behind the 82 as Azarov, who is a fork-off driver, is going for the race lead. He has a run underneath the 18 of Jim Kidd, and he's going to get around him in turns 1 and 2. Great run by Azarov. He's going to retake the race lead as they head down into turns 3 and 4. As the 38 car right in front of him is back on the tail end of the lead lap, and he would love nothing more than to see the caution flag come out, but here comes Azarov back under him to put him back a lap down. As Kidd settles into the second position, with the 16 of Billy Bob Childers running in third, and Kelly Spliceson currently running in the fourth position. But the 38 of Riley Durbin not going to give up as he gets back around the 82 of Lev Azarov to get back on the tail end of the lead lap. And he is now praying for a caution flag right now. And Azarov, though, continuing to lead the race. 18 of Jim Kidd currently running in the second position, with Billy Bob Schroeder's running in the third position right behind him. We haven't heard these two guys' plans yet for next year, whether or not they're going to return to Power Surge America, but I would say safe money is they will be returning in 2017, although there hasn't been any confirmation yet. And here is Mark Thompson, who's made his way back up into the top five already. He just got back on the lead lap at the previous caution, and now he's up to the fifth position. Of course, he still has a lot fresher tires than most of his competitors, and right now he's being clocked as the fastest car on the track right now. So I'll be watching out for that 64 car as the 8 of Bradley Carlisle blows up in turns 3 and 4. That's the second engine failure of the day for Pearson Sweeney Motorsports. Remember, the 2 of Billy Ray Smith Thompson blew up in pretty much the exact same spot in race number 1. The 8 was not able to get back around to the pit lane. As you can see, he stalls in the middle of turn 1 and 2. And that will necessitate the caution coming out on lap number 60, which was the 5th of the day. Lev Azarov continues to lead here on the restart as the Power Surge America teammates run right behind him in 2nd and 3rd. Running underneath is the 60 of Tristan Kristoff, another FARC-off contender, but running in the underpowered Team Burr car this week. And Azarov gets a nice start and actually clears the field and gets a pretty big gap on him at the end of the first lap after the caution flag. Here's a candidate for restart of the year. The 38 of Riley Durbin, who also got back on the lead lap himself, started back in the 14th position, and look at this, going right through the middle of the field. And look at all these cars that he's passing, all these cars on the lead lap. Oh, but he gets hit by the 25 as she turns the 89 of Kira Smith. But the 38 never loses his momentum as he jumps all the way up into the 7th position. And look at that low line he's taking as he gets around Mark Thompson, the 41. And by the time they take the caution flag, Riley Durbin is 3rd. In 2 laps, he gained 11 spots. In my opinion, that is the restart of the year right there. And here's what causes this caution, and Riley Durbin was a little bit of a part of it. 25 of Danica Hallfield gets into the 38, or the 89 of Kira Smith, spinning her around, bringing out the 6th caution of the day here on lap 67. Anthony Griffith looked like he was involved in that one as well. But he was able to continue on, as was Kira Smith in the 89 car. And we come to the final restart of the day. Yes, that was the final caution, with Lev Azarov continuing to lead the way. The 16 of Billy Bob Childress now running in the 2nd position. Riley Durbin was running in 3rd, but he's now under attack from Mark Thompson in the 64 car, as the 16 of Billy Bob Childress, right on the tail of the 82 of Lev Azarov, heading down into turns 1 and 2. But Azarov, even with no front end on that car, whew, got a little bit loose off of turn 2, but he maintains the point right now. But here comes Mark Thompson in the 64 car. He was being clocked as the fastest car on the track not too long ago. And he now has a run underneath the 16 at Billy Bob Childers. That is for the 2nd position. Mark Thompson, who is also in the FARC off based on the fact that he has 2 wins already this season, is now up into the 2nd position and is currently chasing down Lev Azarov in the 82. So, unlike race 1, This battle for the win involves two of the FARC-off drivers, and they know that a win means an automatic berth in the round of 10, and they're not going to give this up without a fight. So this is going to be a good one. Much like race number one, this is coming basically right down to the wire. So fans being treated to some great racing action here tonight, or today rather. And coming around to two laps to go, Azeroth continues to lead the way. But the 64 gets a nice run in turns 1 and 2. The 82 of Azeroth up the track a little bit and scrapes the wall in turn 2. And that's going to allow Mark Thompson to pounce on the 82 and take over the lead in turns 3 and 4. As they come off of turn number 4 to the white flag. Final lap here in race number 2 at Grand Detour. Mark Thompson came into this race on the outside looking in the FARC off, and really didn't know if he was going to be able to qualify for the round of 10 or not, but he's going to put all of that to bed as he comes off of turn 4 and he sees the checkered flags. He wins his third event of the year as he wins race number 2 here at Grand Detour and punches his ticket into the round of 10. Lev Azeroth, even though he came up a little bit short, brilliant run by him, leading the most laps in this race and coming home in second with no front end. Billy Bob Childress comes home in third. Riley Durbin basically rode around in the pit lane in race one, but a brilliant showing here in race two with a fourth place effort. Jim Kidd in fifth. Tyrone Key a sixth place effort. Thomas Tucker, Anthony Griffith, Timothy Ruiz, and Bob Steffens notching their second straight top tens in this race. Of course, Bob Steffens won race one. Tucker finished third in race one. So great runs by all those guys as Bob Steffens, he will be looking to the round of 10. Speaking of which, here are the drivers advancing to the round of 10. First, starting with the drivers who punched their way in based on race victories, of which there are two, both of which happened today. Bob Steffens in the 7 and Mark Thompson in the 64. The next six drivers to make it in will be making it in based on points. And those six drivers will be Lev Azeroth for Roos Autosport, Bradley Carlisle for Pearson Sweeney Motorsports, Kevin Monroe for M&J Racing, Tristan Kristoff, who's driving for multiple teams right now, Johnson Clapp for Wild West Racing, and Chuck Johnson for Cat Motorsports. Which means that there are two spots left, and under the rulebook, the final two spots will be filled by the remaining drivers who are not yet qualified who have the best average finish. So the two lucky drivers who will be advancing to the round of 10 are Joshua Pacer for Jones Sport and Todd Stater for David Hetzel Racing Enterprises. So congratulations to all 10 of these drivers. They will be advancing to the round of 10 to continue their hunt for the FARC Smash Beer Low Dollar Series Championship. And failing to advance, Billy Ray Smith Thompson coming up just short. He had an engine failure in race one. The other four drivers, Leslie Riggs, Daniel Licklider, Kenny George III, and Greg Gray, all fell out of race one due to crash damage and being involved in multiple incidents during that race. Well, that'll do it for us here at Grand Detour here today. The next race for the FARC Smash Beer Low Dollar Series will be the Schiller's Auto Centers 100 at the DuCoin State Fairgrounds in DuCoin, Illinois, the final dirt track race of the season. Thank you for joining us. I'm John Lyondyke, the voice of Bar, and we'll see you next time.